Hare Krishna, today is day 4 of the World Holy Name Week. Today we will see how chanting is the topmost process for realizing God. In Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Krishna mentions different paths by which you can reach the Supreme Lord. In the initial chapters, Krishna tells about Karma Yoga, the path of doing activities for the pleasure of the Lord, by which the process of offering one's services for the Lord, by that also he can come. Either you are a teacher, then do teaching for Krishna. If you are a businessman, do business for Krishna. So that's nothing but Karma Yoga, connecting your activities to God. And Krishna also mentions about Jnana Yoga, the process of cultivating knowledge by reading scriptures and analysis. That's called Sankhya Yoga. And then he also tells about Dhyana in the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, which involves going to meditation, going to the forest, sitting in a secluded place, alone, following strict vows, and tolerating the heat and cold. So by this also, one can elevate, you know, consciousness and reach the Supreme Lord. So this Karma, Jnana and Dhyana Yoga, and Krishna ultimately tells about Bhakti Yoga. Starting from chapter 7 up to chapter 12, Krishna mentions about Bhakti Yoga, which is the topmost system. Arjuna told Krishna that I cannot follow this Dhyana Yoga because it's so difficult. He said that my mind is so unstable and unsteady and restless that I cannot sit like this and do dhyana for a long time. Chanchalam hi manah Krishna pramati balavadhridam tasyaham nigraham manye vayoriva shudushkaram. Arjuna says that it is easy to control the wind, but I cannot control my mind, because mind is chanchala, it is very flickering. It doesn't remain steady, just like a monkey. Just like a monkey keeps jumping from one branch to another, mind also keeps jumping from one thought to another thought. It is difficult to steady it. Pramathi, it is mad. Balavad, it is strong, obstinate, dhridam. So that's why to control the mind is difficult. So Arjuna rejects the process of dhyana and jnana in Bhagavad Gita, because it is difficult to perform for this current age of Kali Yuga, because our lifespan is short. Prayan Alpayusha Sabhya, very short lifespan, 100 years maximum, but average lifespan is 70 years. Prayan Alpayusha Sabhya Kalavasmin Yugejana Mandaha Sumandamati. And people in Kali Yuga, we have less memory, dull mind, because we cannot understand spiritual subject matters. Upadrita, and always disturbed, nowadays because of social media, and so much information, so there is a lot of distraction. So it is difficult to follow dhyana. So that's why Krishna says to Arjuna, bhakti, you practice bhakti. Bhakti is very easy for you to do. So sukham kartum avyayam. It's very easy and joyfully performed. That is bhakti yoga. And in bhakti yoga, there are 9 processes of bhakti yoga. Shravanam kirtanam vishno, Smaranam Pada Sevanam, Archanam Vandanam Dasyam, Sakhyam Atmani Vedanam. Shravanam is hearing about the Lord. Kirtanam is chanting the names of the Lord. Vishnu Smaranam, remembering the Lord. Archanam, offering arati to the Lord. Vandanam, offering prayers. Dasyam, becoming a servant of the Lord. Sakhyam, being a friend of the Lord. And Atmani Vedanam, offering everything in the service of the Lord. So these are the ways, 9 ways in which one can perform bhakti. And among all this, they decide that Tara Madhya Sarva Sreshta Nama Sankirtan. Sankirtan of the Lord is the topmost and it is the best. So that's why Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Kali Yuga has recommended the chanting of Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. By chanting this mantra and by hearing this mantra, one can very quickly attain God realization by overcoming all the unwanted things in his heart and by purifying his heart and realizing the Supreme Lord. So that's why I request everybody, please chant this Hare Krishna mantra. And if you have not yet recorded and uploaded the video, kindly do so in our Telegram group of the ISKCON Cultural Center. Thank you. Hare Krishna.